Hello everyone. In this video, I'll be explaining about organometallic compounds, classification of ligands based on hapticity, 18 electron rule, and synthesis and structure of a few important organometallic compounds. So first coming on to what are organometallic compounds. So as the name suggests, organometallic. So they should be a metal as well as they should be some organic part. Right, so here these are the compounds which have a bond between the metal and the carbon. So here metal atom is directly attached to the carbon atom. So here you can see example organolithium. So here the carbon is directly attached to lithium. These are examples for organomagnesium compounds which are generally referred to as Grignard reagents. So here you can see the magnesium is directly linked to this carbon. So let us take some other examples of organometallic compounds. This is named as tetraethyl lead. So lead is directly coordinated with four ethyl groups. Dimethyl zinc, and this compound is specially named as ferrocene, where iron is sandwiched between two cyclopentadiene rings. So what do you mean by the term hapticity? So hapticity is nothing but the number of carbon atoms of the ligand that are directly bonded to the metal. So it is represented by the Greek letter which is called as eta. So classification of the ligands based on this hapticity, that is based on how many carbon atoms of the ligands are bonded to the metal. So first is monohapto ligand. So monohapto means, as the name suggests, one carbon is directly attached to the metal. So it is represented as eta 1. So some examples are methyl, ethyl, allyl ligand and benzyl ligand. Next is dihapto ligands, where two carbon atoms are attached to the metal. So it is represented as eta 2. So example is ethylene ligand. So here these two carbon atoms are bonded with that of the metal. Next is trihapto ligands, represented as eta 3, where three carbon atoms are associated with the metal. Okay, so it is represented here, the allyl ligand, which is coordinated with the metal, where all the three carbon atoms are involved in the coordination. Okay, so allyl ligand can also coordinate with the metal in the eta 1 form, that is where the terminal carbon is bonded to the metal. But here all the three carbon atoms are bonded to the metal, so we call it as a trihapto ligand. Next is tetrahapto ligand. So as the name suggests, four carbon atoms are coordinated to the central metal. So examples are butadiene and cyclobutadiene. So here what happens is all the four carbon atoms of the ring, that is cyclobutadiene, is coordinated with the ion, whereas here these four carbon atoms are coordinated with the ion metal. So it is named as cyclobutadiene ion tricarbonyl, butadiene ion tricarbonyl. Pentahapto ligands, represented as eta 5. So here you can see here, as I have already given this example of ferrocene, so ion is sandwiched between two cyclopentadienyl rings. So five carbons are coordinated with the central metal. Next, if you are speaking about hexahapto ligands, eta 6, that means six carbons are coordinated with the metal. So simple example is benzene, where all the six carbons of benzene is coordinated with the chromium metal here. So next, coming on to the 18 electron rule. So it is very simple. Here we need to just calculate the number of valence electrons of the metal and the number of electrons that are donated by the ligands. If it comes to 18, then we say that the particular complex is thermodynamically stable. So let us take some few examples so that this concept will be more clear. So let us take example number 1. Okay, here manganese is a central metal and there are 5 carbonyl ligands. So here, atomic number of manganese, as you all know, it is 25. electronic configuration can be written like this. Now we have to count the number of valence electrons in manganese. 5 plus 2 gives 7. Number of electrons that are donated by the ligand. So you know that each ligand will donate 2 electrons each. So 5 into 2. So that will give you 10. So 10 plus 7. What is 18 electron rule? We have to count the number of valence electrons of the metal and total number of electrons donated by the ligand. So here total number of electrons donated by the ligand is 10 and number of valence electrons of the metal is 7. So 10 plus 7 will give you 17. So it is not equal to 18. So what do we say is the compound, that is this complex, is not thermodynamically stable because it is not obeying 18 electron rule. Next, coming on to the second example, where chromium is coordinated with eta 6 benzene. Okay, there are two such benzene which are in the eta 6 form. Okay, so here atomic number of chromium is 24. This is electronic configuration. So if you count the number of electrons in the valence shell, we get it as 6. Next, the number of electrons that are donated by this ligand. So here you have to remember, eta 6 benzene, each eta 6 benzene will donate, okay, here we have 2 eta 6 benzenes, so 1 eta 6 benzene will donate 6 electrons, so here there are 2 such benzenes, so it is 2, so total it gives 12, okay, so 6 plus 12 will give you 18. Now these two, when you add these two, you are getting 18, which indicates that this complex obeys 18 electron rule. And this complex is thermodynamically stable. Yeah. Next, coming on to iron, which is coordinated with 2 cyclopentadienyl rings. So here you know that it is eta 5. So number of electrons to be counted is 5 per ligand. Okay. So make it very clear. For the previous example, since it is 6, we count 6 electrons per ligand. Now it is 5. So 5 electrons per ligand here. Okay. So, the atomic number of iron, as you all know, it is 26. Electronic configuration can be written like this. Next, number of valence electrons, if you count 6 plus 2 is equal to 8. Number of electrons donated by the ligand, so 5 into 2, because there are 2 ligands. So, 5 into 2, 10. So, 10 plus 8 will give you 18. So, since it obeys 18 electron rule, this complex ferrocene is thermodynamically stable. Okay. So next, there are certain complexes where there can be metal-metal bond. So first we need to calculate how to know whether how many metal-metal bonds are present in the complex. So suppose we let us take one example, Mn2CO10. Okay, there are 2 metal atoms. So we don't know whether there is a bond between Mn2Mn atoms or it is linked by carbonyl ligand. Okay, so we have a simple formula. So the number of metal-metal bonds is calculated by this, that is 18 into number of metal atoms minus total valence electrons divided by 2. So how to calculate this TVE, that is total valence electrons? So just you need to add the valence electrons of all these. Okay. So manganese, as we have calculated in the previous example, the number of valence electrons is 7. 7 into 2. Each carbonyl will give 2 electrons, so 2 into 10, so that will give you 34. That is total valence electron of this entire complex. Okay, so 18 into number of metal atoms. Metal atoms here, we know that it is 2, minus TVE is 34, so substitute that, divide by 2. So 2 by 2 will give you 1. That means there is 1 bond between the 2 manganese atoms in this complex. So the structure of the complex is as follows. So you can see here, 2 manganese are held together by 1 metal-metal bond. Okay, and all the carbonyls are lying here. Yeah. Coming on to the next example, CO4, CO12. Okay, so there are 4 cobalt metal atoms and here 12 carbonyl ligands. So here we need to calculate how many bonds are connecting these cobalt metal atoms. Okay, so first let us consider the total valence electrons. So again, cobalt, if you calculate, the atomic number is 27. Number of valence electrons are 9. 4 cobalt atoms are there. So 9 into 4 plus each carbonyl will give 2 electrons. So 2 into 12, that will give you 60. So number of metal-metal bonds is equal to 18 into number of metal atoms is 4 here minus total valence electrons is 60 divided by 2. So that will give you 12 by 2, which is equal to 6. That means these 4 cobalt atoms are linked into each other by means of 6 metal-metal bonds. So the structure is as follows. So here you can see this cobalt 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, you can see the bonds that are connecting them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so there are 6 metal-metal bonds in this complex. Okay, so we are coming back to the 18 electron count again. So let us take this example, Mn2CO10. Now, same thing, atomic number of manganese 25. Electronic configuration can be written like this. So number of valence electron is 7 into how many manganese are there here? 2, so 14. Number of electrons donated by the ligand. So there are 10 ligands. 2 electrons are donated by each carbonyl ligand. So totally 20. Next, we know that there is one metal-metal bond here. So one bond corresponds to 2 electrons. So number of electrons forming metal-metal bond, which is equal to 2. Now we have to count all this, add all this, okay? So you get it as 36. But the effective number of electrons for 18 electron rule is calculated per metal atom, okay? This 36 is for both these manganese atoms, but we need the number of electrons per manganese. So what we have to do, since there are 2 manganese here, this 36 is divided by 2. So that gives you 18, okay? So here, since we get it as 18, this complex obeys 18 electron rule and hence it is thermodynamically stable. Yeah. So this was about the 18 electron rule. So some complexes obey this rule and some complexes violate this rule. Next, coming on to synthesis and structure of some important organometallic compounds. So first one is the ZC salt, okay, which is nothing but potassium trichloroethylene 2 ethylene platinate 2. Okay, so this oxidation number is the same as that of how we calculate for the normal coordination compounds. So you have to substitute the oxidation states for all the other ligands as well as atoms, and then you get the oxidation number of the central metal. Okay, so this is calculated, this is synthesized by making use of potassium tetrachloroplatinate, this complex, in the presence of ethylene to get the compound ZC salt. This is called as ZC salt, and this reaction is carried out in the presence of HCl gas. So structure of this compound, as you can see here, okay, platinum is a central metal and 3 chloro ligands are placed in this way with the ethylene group here. Okay, so these are the 4 ligands which are coordinated with platinum in a square planar geometry. Next, coming on to the second complex, which is nothing but ferrocene. So you know that here iron is between 2 cyclopentadienyl rings. So these are the 2 ligands which are coordinated with the iron in eta 5 fashion. So here we have cyclopentadiene which is reacted with sodium to get the sodium salt of cyclopentadiene. Okay, so one of the hydrogens will be replaced by sodium here. Here you know that there are 2 hydrogens. One hydrogen will be replaced by sodium, okay? So that one hydrogen is removed off. Now, sodium salt of cyclopentadiene is made to react with iron, again in THF medium, to give ferrocene, okay? So we know the structure already. Iron atom is sandwiched between 2 cyclopentadienyl rings, okay? Yeah. So next, coming on to the third complex, that is CR coordinated with 6 carbonyl ligands, hexacarbonyl chromium. And the oxidation state of chromium, as you all know, it is 0 here because carbonyl is a neutral ligand. So oxidation state of chromium will be equal to 0. So synthesis is taking place here. How it is carried out? It is carried out in benzene medium. Okay. So chromium chloride is made to react with the carbon monoxide by making use of a suitable reducing agent like aluminium to give the complex CrCO6. Okay, so structure of this complex, as you all can see here, it's very simple to predict. It is occurring in an octahedral geometry. Okay, here chromium is a central metal which is surrounded by carbonyl ligands in an octahedral fashion. Coming on to the next complex, CO2-CO8, okay, dicobalt octacarbonyl. So how do we prepare this complex? So it is, this reaction is carried out at a very high pressure and high temperature. So we make use of cobalt carbonate. Okay, it is made to react with carbon monoxide in the presence of hydrogen, or I can say it is made to undergo reduction to give CO2-CO8, that is dicobalt octacarbonyl. Okay, so structure, there are two possible structures for this complex. So it can occur as doubly bridged compound, where two carbonyl ligands are acting as bridged, whereas here it is also occurring as unbridged, that is there are no bridging ligands between the two cobalts. Okay, here we call such carbonyls as bridging ligands because they are bridging the two metal atoms. Okay, so these are the two possible structures. Still they have not verified that this complex has only one particular structure among these two. Okay, it can have a doubly bridged structure as well as an unbridged structure. So coming on to the last complex, that is Mn2CO10, dimanganese decacarbonyl. Okay, again synthesis is very simple. It is synthesized at a very high pressure in the presence of magnesium. And since we need a carbonyl complex, it is made to react with carbon monoxide. Okay, so we get the respective compound, that is the respective complex. So the structure of this complex is given as follows. We know that in this compound, we have already calculated that it has one bond between the two manganese atoms, right? We have calculated by using the formula already. So here we have the structure of the molecule, where two manganese are linked by one metal-metal bond and the carbonyl groups are surrounding the manganese atoms. Okay, so if you can see clearly here, okay, the carbon monoxide ligands or the carbonyl ligands are surrounding each manganese in an octahedral fashion. So overall, we call it as the octahedral geometry for this particular complex. Okay, so in this video, I've covered what is meant by 18 electron rule, how do you synthesize a few very simple organometallic compounds, and what are the structures of a few metal carbonyls and some other organometallic compounds, and also about what do you mean by organometallic compounds, the ligands, and how do you classify ligands based on the hapticity. I thank you all for watching the video.